setup to create an application, going back to setup, build, create, apps, new application, custom app, that we are going to discuss custom app. Next, what is the app name? Loading. So description is for a developer purpose. If tomorrow, if you come back to the system, if you want to understand why I created this application, this description will gonna help you. This will not be like a user interactive field. Next, insert image. If I click a insert, what happens?
It goes to the local.
Salesforce local. What is Salesforce local content system? Is documents. There is a tab called documents. The way we had my computer, Salesforce have documents. Documents. It should not be inside my personal documents. If it is a my personal documents, which is accessible by you, it should be like a global folder. Let me say I'm just creating a new document. Document name is learning logo. It should not inside your local. Description keyword, choose a file. Open. Save. Upload it done. Now I need to check my profile permission, risk permissions. Edit. This folder is accessible by all users. That means that it is available for all, right? So I can able to, now what I will do, I'll just click insert image. Now you can see loaning logo. It is not going to your local machine, it is going and looking at a document folder. The Salesforce logo is about 3 KB. To upload image file, new document, documents tab. Must be smaller than 20 KB, it is less than 20 KB, right? Should be maximum 300 pixel wide and 50 pixel. Okay, I'm just vomiting. I don't have image, proper image for that. So all we need to do the same. Okay, it's uploaded. Yes, it's uploaded. Sorry, you can see the image is changed, right? Yeah. Next. Now I'm choosing what is this selected app. And remember, in a classic experience, in a classic, you are not allowed to remove home from a selected tabs. It's a mandatory tab. And it should be the first tab in the order. You can't remove this. Now I'm choosing my accounts, contacts, cases, opportunities, leads. What is my default landing tab that I can choose here? I'm making my accounts is a default landing tab by selecting from default landing tab. What is default landing tab? Whenever I selected an application, it will be targeted and it will be selected as a accounts as a selected tab. That is called default landing tab. Next, and these are profile level security. For now, I'm going with a visible. Save. Now I am in service. As I said, what is our default landing tab? Account. So whenever I select learning, it should open accounts by default. Isn't it open? What is custom application? Custom application is an organized collection of group of tabs, the logo of an application, and name or a label of an application. Clear on this?
Yeah.
So what is tabs? What is tabs? The plural form of an object is called tab. Plural form of an object is called tab, which will help you to create new records or modify your existing records. Tab is nothing but a plural form of an object. Tab is nothing but a plural form of an object, which will help you to create a new records, or it also allows you to modify an existing records. Let's say accounts is my tab. I'm just checking. Now I can see, I can able to access all my accounts. I can able to update. The modifications are possible. If I want to create a new record, I can create my new record. Isn't it? Are we clear on tabs?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, when it comes to tabs, tabs are classified into three types. Tabs are of different types. Tabs are of different types, like S-object tabs, visual force tabs, web tabs, lightning component tabs, lightning page tabs. What is this? If I'm creating a tab using Salesforce object like a standard or custom object, then this tab will be referred as a S-object tab. Okay. If I create a tab using Visual Force, then this is called Visual Force tab. The same way, if I would say web tab, if I wanted to open a Google inside a Salesforce, then I create a web tab. So it will just load an iframe within the Salesforce so that you can also accessible to Google. Okay. Lightning component is, we'll discuss these things on Lightning development. Are we clear on this? Okay. So I'm just going for a tab section. Tab. Now we can see a different tab. Custom object tabs, web tabs, Visual Force tab, Lightning component tabs, and Lightning page tabs. Okay. If I want to create a web tab, I don't want to touch now. Let it be. Accounts. So accounts, contacts, cases, or tabs. What are the objects for this? Are we created these objects, or it's actually given by a Salesforce? Okay. If it is something given by a Salesforce, then those things are referred as a standard, as a out-of-box functionality. Standard objects, standard tabs, right? These are standard tabs. Can we make a new S-object custom tab? How to do? If we want to create a tab, what we needed? Plural form of an object. Plural form of an object is called tab. So, first we need to have an object in order to create a tab for you. First, we need to have an object in order to create a tab for you, right? So let me create it quickly. How to create an object? How to create an object?
Setup.
Setup.
Object.
Build. Object. Build. create, object. Setup, build, create, object. New custom object. I'm naming this as a mortise. I'm going this example as a mortise. The plural form of a tab is nothing but a plural form of an object is nothing but a tab. What is plural form for mortise? But this is not an actual English meaning of plural form. Plural form is just for a naming convention they are using for a tab. You can always write budget, whatever you wanted, anything is fine. So I'm just going with the mortgages. And now if I say if I'm creating a table, if I'm creating a table, what is the minimum requirement for a table?
Satisfaction contain one column.
At least one column. That column is nothing but a this one. Record name, label, or a format. Record name, label. Record name is actually of two data types. One is text data type, and another is auto number. Why this is text? Salesforce is having a generic data types other than the standard data types like string, integer. Instead of going with that, they are using some generic data types with an inbuilt validations. If it is a text, it will accept everything. If it is auto number, it will generate a series of number. So I can say mortise name is text. And now you can see optional features. What is this option? Allow reports. So if I check this one, you can able to do a reporting on this object. You can able to track the activities on this object. And if any field is changing, that old value and new value you can able to track as a field tracking history in charter groups. Deployment, allow search. What is allow search? If I enable allow search, I can able to search my record, mortgage record from a global search. From this, okay? Now I'm adding notes and attachments. Launch new custom tab. Save. I need to choose my tab style. Next. Here you can see tabs are of having a different profile permissions like default on, default off, tab hidden. What is default on? Default on, you will get everything on a header, I mean tab section. If it is a default off, which will be available inside all tabs, which will be available inside all tabs. Now I'm just making this as a default off and I'm continue. Save. Now I can see all tabs. Here I'm just finding where is mortise. Here we have. So can we enable this as a default on tab? Can I able to get? I mean, can I able to customize my mortise to next to opportunity?
Yes.
So if I customize my tabs, I can able to place wherever I wanted. But let me ask you this question. Is this gonna change, affect all users or only for you?
Only for you.
This is not become as a default on tab for everyone. This is only become on place. You just customized your sequence of tabs. It's not something your administrator provided, right? So it's an individual customization. So you can able to get the available tabs based on your convenience. It doesn't mean that it's a default on. It's actually a default off, but you customized yourself to place it here for your user, right?
Yeah.
Okay. If I go back, if I want to create a new, I can able to create a new record. So we know how to create an object, right?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. So if I say, how many types of relationships we have in Salesforce?
3 types.
What are they?
It has red color, mandate relationship.
Okay, master detail.
Master detail.
Next one. Lookup relationship. And third one, external lookup relationship. So, what is master detail? Master detail is a parent-child relationship. Master detail is a parent-child relationship, which is a mandatory in child object, which is a mandatory in order to create a child record, which is mandatory. Whenever you delete your parent record, whenever you delete your parent record in a master detail relationship, all child records will get deleted. Whenever you delete a master record, parent record in a master detail relationship, all related child account or records will get deleted. The same way, if you restore the parent, all child records and its history will get restored. Okay, where in lookup relationship? Lookup is an optional relationship. If you delete your parent record, the child record parent field will get referenced. I mean, if I have a child relationship named as an account as a lookup, if I delete my account in a mortgage, what happens? Only account field get become null. Rest record will exist in the system. Okay, only the reference will go off to the field. If the field value is account, yeah, ACC1, if I delete ACC1, ACC will get removed from that field, record will exist in the lookup, where in master detail, entire record will get deleted. Okay, external lookup is actually you can make a lookup relation with an external table that we'll talk. We have two types of tables, like a standard custom, external objects. External objects, if you want to make a lookups, then you can use external lookups. Now I'm just going to create a new field. How to create a field in an object, custom object?
New.
Setup, that is a record. If I want to create a new field, I need to go to setup, build, create, objects, which object? Mortgage. And then custom fields. Which field I'm talking about? Master detail. Now I'm creating a master detail. Next. Account. Next. Account name. This is. Please select the account name. Now you can see read only, allow users with the least record access. This will talk about sharing rules. Child records can be reparented to other parent. What does it mean? What is reparenting? After creation of my mortgage, if I wanted to update to other account, then that is called reparenting. Right? I created an account mortgage with a ACC1. Later I realized that it is not related to ACC1. It should be under ACC2. So what happened, if this is not checked, you are not allowed to change your parent. I mean, you are not allowed to change from ACC1 to ACC2. If this is checked, then you can able to do a reparent of your child record. I mean, mortgage can be reparented from existing account to the other account. Okay? Clear. Next. Now we can see new. So I can able to choose values, right? Let's say United But let's say, let me go to accounts, new, sorry, all accounts. Let me edit columns. I'm just adding a rating called rating. Next, save. I wanted to select mortgage only records which contain warm. Only rating which contains warm, then those accounts only I need to select. Okay. What I'm trying to say here is, if I'm creating a new record, if I'm creating a new record in a mortgage, if I click a lookup, I need to filter out only those accounts which are related to warm. Okay. Rating should be warm. Account rating should be warm. Those accounts are eligible to create a mortgage. Are we clear on this? Okay. To create that. So what I'm trying to say here is, I wanted to filter it out. I wanted to drill down my records to a based on criteria. It's not like a open. Let's say United Island Gas is not actually a rating is hot. Right? United. I can able to select, right? Still. But this is not a hot, warm record, right? Now, what I need to do, I need to apply a condition so that it will filter for me. So, if I wanted to see, let me check whether do I have any option at a field level. I'm going to the same place, setup, create, objects, mortgage, and I'm just opening account name, custom field. I'm seeing, you can see there is something called lookup filter, right? So we'll see what happens here. Lookup filter, what is saying? Optionally create a filter to limit the records available to user in the lookup field. So there is something they are talking about to filtering. We'll see. What is the field suggestion? Insert suggested criteria. What is this? No. Account name. Rating, right? Where is rating here? Rating. Insert. Equals. What is our value? Warm, right? Now you can see required or optional. It's a required or an optional. If it is a required, it means that user have to follow this. If it is optional, he can also clear. Let me say first time it is required. Only warm accounts are eligible to create mortgage. Save. So what I will do now, I'll go to mortgage, new, let me see which records I'm getting. Only warm accounts are eligible to create a mortgage. That was we provided, right? Lookup window text. Now if I search United, before it was coming, now you can see, no, it's not coming. It will come only warm records. Right, only warm. Brington is an warm, rating is warm. And do we have any option to skip off this results? No, right? It's a mandatory that I need to select only the related accounts which are warm. Let's say business also have requirement that by default they wanted to filter out the data, but it's an optional that user can choose anything. So for that, it is not a required field type. All they will be saying that optional. If it is optional, what happens? They will be having a separate button to clear out. Let's say optional. Now you can see results are show all results. If I say United, by default it will not come. University of Azora is a warm, but I wanted to say United Oil and Gas. So, if I say show all results, now you got it. We got it, all records. If I reapply my criteria, it will go off. So it's an optional. So it's like a default we are making users to select only those accounts. If it is not, then they can also choose an all from all accounts. Clear? How we can filter out the results in a lookup fields? How we can filter out the results in a lookup fields? Using lookup filters. In lookup filters, what options we have? Required, optional, right? Required and optional. Clear? Srikanthanna? Clear? Vinita?
Yep, clear.
Okay. So, we did mortgage, right? Let me go to custom fields. Back to mortgage. I'm just creating a new field called pick list. Okay. Status. Here you have use global value sets and enter values with a separated by a new line. Now I'm writing the first value using separated values by entering manually. Let's say open in progress, closed won, closed lost. Do you want to display alpha values in alphabetical order or in the order I entered? I'm just saying in the order I entered. If I select required field, what happens? This field will get required at a object level. So I'm not recommended to do required at a object level. Next, visible for all profiles. These are the profile permissions. For now, we are going with visible for all profiles. Save. So we have another field in place in the status, right? This field is created by what? Are we using anything or we just entered all values strictly? We just entered all values at a field creation, right? Okay. So we also, if you see, while creating a pick list, we also have another option. We do have another option saying that use global pick list. There is a concept called use global pick list value set. What is mean by? If I wanted to, let's say progress, new, all these are reusable attempts if it is in a business process. So what I will do, instead of retyping everything again and again, I'll create one library type of field. I can always refer to that field. So how to create that field? All we need to go pick list value sets. Build, create pick list value sets. Pick list value sets. Create a new substatus. All you need to provide your values like working, interested, promoted, not interested, qualified, not applicable. Save. I just save. What I will do, I'll go back to my fields. What is this menu called? Quick access menu. If I am in a mortgage object, if I access this object, it will open up my mortgage object details. Let's say view object. So which object was opened? Mortgage. Now I am creating a new field with a pick list data type using global pick list. Now I can see, I can select my substatus directly. So what happens? All the values which I entered will be inherited to this object. I don't want to retype it. If tomorrow I wanted to add, let's say I created a substrate of almost 20 times in a project. But tomorrow, if I want to add two more values inside a pick list, it would be if I don't use the library, then I need to update in 20 places, right? If I'm using my library, if I update one place, it will be reflected in all references. It's easy to manage your drill down values. Substatus. Next. Save. Now you can see. It actually comes all values inherited. Substatus, right? Only NA. If tomorrow, if I wanted to say, I want to add a new value. I wanted to add a new value. Let's say. No budget. Now it will ask, add a new pick list value to all record types. Until or unless you don't select this, it will not add. If we want to add to everything, then you need to select. If we want to add the new drop down to the object reference, then you need to select a checkbox called add the new pick list values to all record types that use in this global value set. Save. Now we can see. Refresh. Does it add it? Right? Added or not? Added, right? Okay, let's say I'm creating a new close and I'm not selecting this, I'm just saving. Why it is came up now? I didn't select it. As I said, if you select that record, then only it will add to all record types, right? But now let me ask, do we have any record type for this object? Are we created any object on this?
No.
Record type we didn't create it. So let me create a quickly one record type. Record types. There is no record types. If we have record types, then only that functionality will get applied. Record types. Mortgage. Enable. Next. Page layouts, fine, save. Now I'll create a new. Now I'll create a new value here. Whoa. I didn't select it. Now you can see refresh. You got it. The value which I entered is a own, right? But it is not available. But it is not available. Right or wrong? It is not available. Why it is not available? Because I didn't selected a checkbox called add to all record types where and all this field is referred. Right? So if I want to add that field, what I need to do? I need to go to my object. I need to go to my object. What we are trying to do? We need to add. Which one? We need to add own drop-down value to which? To a record type. To a record type of what? Mortgage object record type. I just wanted to go to mortgage object record type. Open the record type. Which field you want to update? Substatus, right? Edit substatus and you will be having available fold. All you need to select to add. Save. Now it will be available for you to create and record, right? So if it is a global, how from this what we need to understand, you can able to control your drop down values using what? Using record types. You can able to control your drop down values using record types. Clear? Clear and okay. So if I say, let me ask you this way. If I selected closed lost, closed won't. So what could be the substrate? Can I select closed? I mean otherwise no budget. Is this a relevant information? I'm saying this is closed won, but I'm now I'm saying let me say not interested. Is this or good? No, if we can see, if it is a closed won, it should be something else. Why it is not interested as a substatus, right? It's a closed won means I actually completed successfully. Now, what it is talking about? Not interested. Not interested means? What is this? So, he is not interested. So, there is no meaning. Which one I need to consider? Substatus or a status? Right? So, what I am trying to do here is, if I select closed won, I need to select those records. It need to display only those fields which are relevant to a won status. If I select lost, it should display only those fields which are relevant to a status. If I don't select anything, this field should be hidden. This field should be non-editable. What here I'm talking about some dependency. Dependency of what? Based on my status pick list, my substatus need to be modified. Need to be shown up with a different values when I select. So for that, what we have, Salesforce also have a standard functionality called field dependency. Salesforce also have a standard functionality called field dependencies. Let me go to the custom object of mortgage. And you just see the next to new at the custom fields and relationship, there is a button called field dependencies. There is a button called field dependencies. Click on this. It will guide you to select the controlling field. What is the controlling field in our case? Status. Status. What is dependent field? Substatus, continue. So for a new, what could be the possible? Working, promoted, interested. Okay, these are the two fields. All you need to select the values and you can do include. If it is a open, then I can say open, interested, promoted, not qualified. Let's say included. Included, in progress means working, qualified, include. Include means it will add to the value. If it is like closed won means won, qualified. Closed lost means I can say closed, not applicable, no budget, not interested. So what I'm doing here, so you can see working I'm selecting everywhere. So you can select the same status again and again for a multiple values. It's not for a same value that I'm selecting. I'm selecting for a, what is status open? If I select status open, what is the applicable substatus? If I select open, what is the applicable values? This is what include means which will add, exclude means which will remove. I'm just saving. Now I'm going back here. I'm just doing a refresh. Now what happened? This field is hidden by default, right? Clear? Yeah. If I select closed lost, you can see only those status which are related to closed lost, which we selected here. Which we selected here. Closed lost, not interested, NA, no budget, closed won. Now we can see, are this the same? Not interested, NA, no budget, closed. If I select new, then fields are changing, right? If I select promoted, now I can change in progress. Automatically, this field will be dereferenced, right? So how we are getting this functionality? By using what? Field dependencies. In field dependencies, what we have? Control field and dependent field. Now, let me ask, whenever we are creating a field dependencies, why didn't we get mortgage name? We got only two fields called status and substatus.
Because inside of mortgage application.
Sorry?
We are doing it inside of mortgage tab.
No, nothing like that. Field dependency you can't do in all fields. You can able to do field dependencies only pick list,
custom,
checkbox and multi-select. You can able to do only three field data types. Pick list, checkbox, and multi-select. Okay, there is a...
So, pick list is in Mortel, so it's...
If it is, I mean, whatever pick list we have in Mortel, those are eligible to have a field dependencies. It's not for all data types. Only for three data types it is eligible. First one is pick list, checkbox, and multi-select pick list. Only three data types are eligible to create a field dependencies. Because if it is a text field, how can you say that it's a field dependency? Today I write my name is Lakshmi Deepak. Tomorrow I'll write that IL Deepak. So we can't guarantee, right? You can able to do only those values which are standard. Standard, which they need to select. The selected values, we have only three types. One is like pick list, multi-select and checkbox. And one more thing. Multi-select cannot be a controlling field. Remember that multi-select cannot be a controlling field. Multi-select always a dependent field. Multi-select always a dependent field. Clear on this? Let me create a new field quickly. I'm just creating one multi-select pick list. Pick list multi-select is another data type. Next, sub status v2. I am selecting the same. Continued. Visible to all. Save. Now there is a multi-select, right? So what I want to do, whenever I select a status, let's say here I selected, if I say working, then I need to select a dependent, then only my version 2 need to be enabled. Now what I can do, I can also do again field dependency, new field dependency. Now in controlling field, you got any subversion 2? Substatus version 2, now you didn't get, right? But in a dependent field, you got it, you can see, right? So, substatus version 2, continue. Now you can do the same thing, working, included, interested. Promoted, not interested, qualified, next, NA, no budget, closed. I'm just selecting the same values, one-on-one mapping, refresh, now which is not applicable, it's not a value, it's a like a none what we have, the same way it is non-editable. New, working. You got the value? There is a dependency, right? But we need to remember that multi-select pick list cannot be a controlled field for at any point of time. Multi-select field cannot be a controlling field at any point of time. And other one we discussed like a checkbox, right? Let's say, new custom field, I'm saying another checkbox which is I'm making as a is active, uncheck, previous, visible to all, next, save. Now I'll go back my field dependency and I'll create a field dependency to a checkbox. Checkbox can be a controlling field. Whenever there is a checkbox, you don't have a multi-select pick list. You remembered. If the controlling field is a checkbox, dependent field, it will not control. Dependent field is only pick list. Dependent field is only pick list, not a multi-select. Clear on this? Generally what happened, multi-select cannot be a controlling field. That's a earlier scenario. In the current scenario, if it is a checkbox, multi-select cannot be a dependent, right? Continue.
For a check, why substatus didn't come for dependent?
Sorry? Substatus is already a dependent field on status field, right? So if I say that again this is a substatus, then it would be a problem. What happened? Substatus is already a dependent field. So you can't make the same field dependent on two fields.
Okay.
Clear. If I say that substatus is also dependent, if I check that checkbox, if I don't select status, what happened? This field will not come. Just a control. In a real case, it won't be a scenario that you will be having a two dependent fields. I mean, for one field, two controlling.
Okay.
Is active. So for is active, I am saying closure lost. Uncheck closure lost. For own, I am saying that new and everything. Save. Now I am going back and reading. But generally, this is not a case, right? It should not come here. For uncheck, you are seeing only those results which are closure lost. If I select check, then the value. Is this in a right order? Is this in a right order? No, right? How to modify this order? The one we are seeing is a page layout. Edit layout. Status. Save. Now you can see. If I uncheck, I have closure lost. If I check, if I say active, then it is asking what is the status, right?
Yeah.
Are we good on this?
Yeah.